Well, it started off it's been two Wednesdays now, where I just felt like I had allergies. And so I just assumed that was all that was happening. So I continued life like I would normally do. Shouldn't have done that, because that means that I was around a lot of people, which now are having to quarantine. Luckily, none of them are sick. So that's really good because I was wearing a mask. But it did affect even work. I went in while I was sick, not knowing that I was. It reduced hours for everybody. So all of my coworkers, that means they're not being able to be paid because they're having to be quarantined, or the ones that are not having to be quarantined, we are only open 5 days or 5 hours a day. So that means that they can't get that full time that they need without having to work 7 days in a week. Luckily we are able to go back this Thursday when everyone is out of quarantine. It doesn't just affect me. It affected my work, affects my church, my school, I have practicum. Like, I've got a lot of things that I've had to step back. I'm not able to do. My family-wise, because I still live at home, I have my mom and dad and then a baby brother, and they all had a quarantine. Mom and dad tested positive, so it spread through my family. I didn't even intentionally do that. I was in my room like I was supposed to. I know after the first few days, on that Monday, I was very sick. It literally took me 30 minutes to eat a small breakfast pizza. I was in tears because I couldn't breathe. It was not fun. Well, I definitely was like, I won't get it. Like, I knew people got it. I knew it was real. And I know the severity of it with like people that have problems, older people and stuff like that. But I definitely didn't think that I would be getting it. So that's changed obviously now of like how easily anybody can get it. It's real. And honestly, just because like maybe my symptoms weren't as severe as somebody else's, but I could give it to somebody that maybe has lung issues that it could actually affect and it can actually kill. And me as a person, I don't want that to happen. That's scary. Like, if I get it, it's one thing because I know that I'm able to fight it off, but other people, they won't be able to. And like, I don't want to put them in that situation. So when I do get together with some friends, like right now, it's just a smaller group of us. I still like keep my distance, so we're like in a circle. So trying to keep that a little bit. But otherwise, you still are able to get that interaction. You're still able to get together with people. It's just, you need to be more cautious than before. So it's our responsibility as people, as a society, needing to go out, be cautious of everything that we're doing, maintaining that distance, wearing our mask, and just making sure that we're not infecting other people. It's not just all about you. I know that can be a problem, but it's about other people, about ones that are not able to fight it off, about ones that could potentially die from it. So making sure that they are safe, not just you.